My name's Cam and I'm from Rippple Books, and thank you all for coming here tonight. It's really great on a Sunday night. It's minus two outside and it's wonderful to see you all here at the reading tonight. We are presenting the Book of Names, which is the white book over there by Royce, Leville. And we also have music tonight from Joel Saracula. There are 20 stories in the book, and there are 20 objects on the cover, and there are also 20 books on the back. So I quite like that cover, very much the back side, because the stories are like small books. Marla's going to read the story Esmeralda.
The murmurs of the audience die down as the ringmaster walks towards the circle of light projected from the lone spotlight, positioned just slightly to the left in the center ring. He's skinny, quite tall, and wearing a dark purple suit that appears to be made of velvet. The suit jacket has tails, and there's a monocle attached to the lapel. He puts the monocle in place in his left eye. It lends him an old-world sense of entitlement and grandeur, like a faded aristocrat fallen on hard times. The ringmaster proved in the first half that he was a man of few words, that these incredible acts required little introduction. But he actually appears rather bored with the whole thing, that he had, perhaps, once failed at a more regular and respected profession, and somehow through the course of happenstance and wrong turns, had ended up here in a purple velvet suit, introducing amateur weirdness passed off as entertainment. He raises the microphone. "Ladies and gentlemen," he says in a monotone, "I give you the astonishing, the mesmerizing Esmeralda." The lights go out. There's a soft humming as several ultraviolet lamps are switched on, bathing the center ring in a soft neon purple glow. Small specks are visible on the carpet and could be bits of confetti or drops of the knife catcher's blood. For a while, nothing happens. Then something starts moving behind the curtains, an animal on all fours, black and white with the white glowing through the thin curtains, an animal on the prowl, moving slowly. Everyone watches for movement, for this animal to appear. He thinks it's some kind of a big cat, maybe a tiger. He hopes so. Esmeralda the white tiger,